everyone, it's Caroline. You have learned so much throughout this unit. By now, you're an expert at evaluating square roots, identifying and naming parts of triangles, finding the legs and hypotenuse on a right triangle, and you can even use the Pythagorean Theorem to find a missing side in a right triangle. Sure, these topics are all going to be very important throughout future math classes, but I know what you're really waiting for. Figuring out if Josh can fly his drone to my house! At the beginning of this unit, I told you about my friend Josh's new drone and how we wanted to figure out if he could fly it to my house. We saw our neighborhood and the potential paths of the drone. Since the drone can fly, it can travel over the hypotenuse instead of the legs of this right triangle. We learned at the start of this unit that the lengths of the legs are 900 feet and 1,200 feet, and that the range of the drone is 1,800 feet. But we don't know the length of the hypotenuse. Does this picture look familiar to you from the work you've been doing? A right triangle with two sides whose lengths we know and one side that we'd like to find. This is a job for the Pythagorean Theorem. Although the triangle's legs are 900 and 1,200 feet, to help make this problem a little simpler to calculate, let's use 9 and 12 for the lengths of each leg, since they represent the number of hundreds of feet in the length. Take a moment here to pause this video and solve for the length of hypotenuse of the right triangle Josh's drone makes. Check your work here. Did you get a side length of 15, which represents 1,500 feet? Nice job! That means that if the drone flies directly from Josh's house to my house, it will have to travel 1,500 feet. So, what's the verdict? Will Josh's drone be able to fly to my house? Yes! Because 1,500 feet is within the range of 1,800 feet. Woohoo! I cannot wait to tell Josh how much you've helped us, and I'm even more excited to be able to see his drone in action. Now that you've helped me and Josh, let me give you some advice. Since you've finished learning all of the information in this unit, it's time to get ready for your final unit assessment. Before you jump into it, take some time to make sure you're up for it. You'll find an assessment preparation checklist in your notes template to help you make sure you're ready to be successful. Have an adult check over your responses. After completing your checklist, feel free to get a snack, take a break, move around, or try anything else that may help you feel as good as possible before going into your unit assessment. When you feel your best, you can do your best. Good luck and keep working hard, and I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.